Now, meantime, as the world looks on from abroad, many are still levying primary criticisms on Israel's doorstep, all while ignoring the fact that Hamas is a terrorist organization bent on the destruction of Israel, America, and the eventual deaths of both Jews and Christians worldwide, among other things. At least one man pointing out the seemingly obvious, though, in a recent piece titled "The Truth About the Hamas Terrorist Organization." With me in studio is author of the book Industry of Lies, journalist at Ynet, and attorney Dror Yemini. Dror, it's a pleasure to have you back with us. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
So, first of all, what was your onus, what was the driving force behind writing this piece specifically?
Because I do read and I do hear many people. I do hear from my friends in Paris, in New York, telling me about, in New York, telling me about Jews who participate in demonstrations in favor of the Hamas and against Israel. Mm-hmm. And I'm asking myself, okay, it's fair enough to be humanist, to be liberal, to be progressive, fair enough. I mean, partly I'm too. The point is that they have no idea what is a Hamas, what they're looking for, what is their aim. And their aim is not Israel. People should know it. The leaders of the Hamas, just listen to them. They are saying, we want to conquer Rome. We want to conquer, I'm quoting, the two Americas. I mean, they are part of the global jihad, just like the Islamic State. What they want is actually a total destruction with a kind of caliphate that will control the world. Don't they understand it? No, they do not. Don't they know it? No, they do not. And many times, well, it's a failure. Let's admit, it's a failure of Israel. If people who demonstrate against Israel, if those uncles that are so humanist, they do care about the people in Gaza, where have you been when the United States and the coalition bombarded in Baghdad, in Afghanistan, in Iraq, and so many civilians, innocent civilians, were killed? How comes that all what you have in mind is to criticize Israel, the only one state?
Well, so I read in your piece that you chalk it up, at least in part, to a great ignorance on the part of third-party observers and people who are protesting from abroad and really don't know necessarily the ins and outs of this. Yeah. But we're hearing similar things from the AP, from Al Jazeera, who have Hamas firing from right underneath their feet.
Yeah.
Do they not know? Are they ignorant?
Sometimes, you know, it's not that they don't know. Some people do not know. But those people that you're talking about, intellectual journalists, they should know. They are supposed to know.
So why do they ignore that fact?
Hatred. I mean, they went out of their mind. Hatred. I don't know if to say anti-Semitism. Not everyone out there, and we cannot always say anti-Semitism and so on. But when we are speaking about intellectuals, we had enough. I don't want to explain them. You're asking me to explain what? I don't want to explain them. I want to put the facts on the ground and to tell them, you are hypocrites. You are inciting against one state that is fighting terror. They are looking for killing all of us. And you are blaming us for defending ourselves? I mean, what a chutzpah.
So that actually brings me to another piece, because we've got tons of international condemnations, especially coming from the UN, the EU, et cetera. And it seems that even when they call for calm on all sides, which I think we can all agree that is a goal that we can support, somehow Israel's still singled out. For example, I have EU foreign policy chief Joseph Borrell maintaining Israel's right to self-defense, but only in a proportionate manner. What does that mean?
Let's do something, I mean, that they will never accept. Let's compare. How many you killed in, for example, Kosovo in 1999? Innocent civilian comparing to soldiers. Combatants against non-combatants. Let's compare. And I'll tell you something. I mean, if you are an expert about the military battlefields, it's time to know that Israel killed much less proportionally comparing to any other battle of that kind. I mentioned Afghanistan and Iraq. Not only. Even in Libya when they bombarded. How many civilians were killed? I mean, how come that you complain about one state when you killed much more, absolutely and proportionally? So, and then they criticize Israel, hypocrites.
Well, I'll even take it, I mean, let's play devil's advocate and take the argument seriously that there is a line at which point the response is disproportionate. What is that line?
They crossed the line. Israel never did. Great question. They crossed the line, because I can show you the numbers, which, of course, I compiled and researched in my book. And if you can contradict my data, do it. You cannot. You cannot, because you know that I'm telling the truth, and you are lying again and again. It's not criticism anymore. It's not criticism anymore. I mean, because to criticize, I mean, we do it ourselves. In Israel, it's a free country. 80% of the journalists are criticizing the government. We don't need your interference, which is helping the Hamas. That's what you're doing.
All right. So, author of Industry of Lies, journalist Ben Dror Yemini, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.